Hi, my name is Barış Bayram. I'm a PhD candidate at Istanbul Technical University in Computer Engineering Department. Here, I will be presenting our new work about real-time auditory scene analysis using continual learning in real environments. Continual learning, also known as lifelong learning, is a continuous process for incremental learning from streaming data in real environments. During this process, new knowledge about the objects such as events, actions, humans, and even noises is adapted into the learning model. Analyzing acoustic scenes is one of the major applications of audio perception because there is a mixture of sounds in real acoustic environment that is obtained from multiple sound sources, background noises, and so on. It is also known as the cocktail party problem, and it aims to understand the relationships and efficiently labeling of entities in the environment, such as events, actions, humans and objects, or stationary or non-stationary noises. For scene analysis, we need to recognize a known object and then to adapt its new knowledge into the scene analysis model. Also, it is required to detect unknown objects in real environments. However, when an unknown object is detected, we have only a few knowledge about it. Therefore, we have utilized an object-wise algorithm for this continual learning-based scene analysis framework. In this work, we used acoustic events as objects. Basically, in this continual learning process for scene analysis, this adaptation of new knowledge and model generation for new events continues in a lifelong manner. The real-time auditory scene analysis framework is composed of five main stages. The first one is feature extraction that includes sound source localization, audio pattern segmentation, and extraction of low-level audio features. The other one is acoustic event recognition. Unknown event detection and model generation are the other stages in this framework. The unknown event detection is actually performed based on the outputs of acoustic event recognition model stage, and the model generation is achieved using film knowledge after an unknown event is detected. And the fifth stage is continual learning by retraining. This is our proposed framework that includes two main processes. One is the offline initial model generation, and the other one is a real-time scene analysis process. All the stages are applied to the signal stream captured from a microphone array. In this work, for real-time scene analysis, it was aimed to develop fast and robust techniques to meet the demands of real-time processing. I will explain all the stages in detail. In the real-time scene analysis process, the first stage is feature extraction. There are three tasks employed in this stage, in which the initial one is sound source localization, used for detection and monitoring of a source. After the localization, audio patterns are segmented on the streaming signal of this detected source. Then for each pattern, audio features are extracted to construct a feature set, which is a time series. Because in this work, as object-wise model, we used hidden Markov model with hierarchical structure, which is a time series-based algorithm. The localization is required to discriminate the target sources from the non-stationary noises and non-target sources. Also, the spatial information may carry essential cues depending on the characteristics of the scene. In this work, generalized eigenvalue decomposition based multiple signal classification method is employed, which performs noise robust localization and is quickly able to estimate the azimuth angle of multiple sound sources. Using this method, a source is being monitored over its location to process its streaming signal in a scene analysis pipeline. The aim of the segmentation is to distinguish the audio pattern of an event from silence and another sound event. A pattern actually has a boundary with an onset and offset frames on the streaming signal of the detected source. It basically aims to detect peak frames using the energy features like shown in this figure, in which the red lines represent the onset and the blue ones represent the offset frames. After the segmentation, a feature set is constructed for each audio pattern that includes a number of feature vectors, as many as the length of the pattern. Therefore, different capsule, spectral and temporal types of audio features listed in this table are evaluated in terms of event recognition performance and computational time of the continual learning process. Also, using Kullback-Leibler distance, the feature selection is employed to reduce the computational time of this continual learning process by retraining. The hierarchical hidden Markov model used in this work is actually composed of two layers, in which the lower layer includes one hidden Markov model for each event, and all HMMs are utilized for acoustic event recognition by comparing the best likelihood value with an event-wise threshold that is dynamically updated. But if the features are not recognized, the feature set is combined with its Viterbi sequence to be used in upper layer. And the upper layer has only one hidden Markov model for all events used for unknown event detection. A likelihood value called as nullity likelihood is computed by this upper hidden Markov model using the combined feature set. And then this value is compared with a suspicion threshold that is also dynamically updated. According to this comparison, the feature set is detected as a new event or undefined event because of the low precision. Firstly, the constructed feature set is utilized in acoustic event recognition stage. If the features are recognized by using the best likelihood value and this likelihood threshold, these are used for retraining the time series based models. But if not recognized, the set is combined with their Viterbi sequence, which is the output of acoustic event recognition stage. And then the combined feature set is detected as undefined or unknown events by comparing the nullity likelihood with the suspicion threshold. After the detection of unknown event, a model is generated using this feature set. Also, it is aimed to develop a continual learning ability to be able to adapt new knowledge, retain previously learned knowledge, and insert new events. Therefore, to achieve these abilities, it is required to retrain the models for continual learning. Also, like feature selection, to reduce the computational time for retraining, we evaluated hidden Markov models for each event to estimate optimal number of iterations for training and number of states. In the offline initial model generation process, being a separate pipeline, at least one initial model is generated using one, a few, or several audio patterns before real-time scene analysis. In this process, also the previous feature sets and their Viterbi sequences are retained to be used in retraining. These are the software and hardware settings used in the experiments. For real-time sound source localization, HARC, which is an open-source robot audition software, is utilized. For hidden Markov model and evaluations, HMMLearn and scikit-learn libraries are employed respectively. For the audio feature extraction stage, Libros and Pymer, the audio Python libraries, are utilized. Also, the experiments were performed by a computer with Intel quad-core i7 3700K with 16 GB RAM on the recordings taken by Kinect microphone array with 4-channel. In the first part of experiments, namely the offline experiments, the audio feature set and parameters for the models learned for unknown event detection and acoustic event recognition were estimated. so that they can be later used in real-time experiments. For these offline experiments, the recordings captured in a domestic environment have been utilized. The table demonstrates the number of sounds and number of audio patterns segmented from the sounds. In these offline experiments, a bunch of domestic sounds such as being recorded from opening and closing doors, footsteps, kettle, vacuum cleaner, washing hands, dishwasher, toilet flush, and washing machine have been generated in the near vicinity of a microphone array. In the first offline experiments, we need to estimate the most appropriate capsular feature that will comprise the major part of the feature set, and to estimate the promotive features to the capsular one in the spectral and temporal features. The acoustic event recognition performance in terms of accuracy and F1 score using the well-known capsular features are shown in this table. Also, the retraining time is measured under the worst scenario in which most of the feature sets is retrained. MFCC and MFCC with their derivatives have the best prediction performances. However, it is decided to prefer only MFCCs by considering the dimension of the features and the computational time required with respect to the dimension. As the table illustrates, using the variations of features with one dimension, that are spectral features, energy, and zero crossing rate, the performance either degraded or not improved remarkably. Furthermore, to decrease the computational time, the Kullback-Leibler distance-based feature selection is applied on the 13-dimensional MFCC features. For the MFCC and selected coefficients of MFCC, the average recognition accuracy of lower hidden Markov models and the average computational times of prediction and retraining of an hidden Markov model in the worst case are listed in this table. Based on these results, we utilize four-dimensional selected MFCCs in the next experiments, including the real-time experiments. In this table, the results of hierarchical HMM are demonstrated in the scenarios in which only 1, 3, or 5 events are known, or only one event is unknown. The performance of unknown event detection is evaluated when the selected 3 and 5 events are not similar to each other, and at least one event similar to the unknown one is known. Also, the time required for the detection of one unknown event is investigated. It is a sample of an unknown event detection experiment demonstrated in this figure, in which the suspicion threshold represented by the red point and the likelihood values of unknown events that are dish machine, door closing, and vacuum cleaner computed by the upper hidden Markov model are shown. The correctly detected patterns are represented by the blue points, and the patterns detected as undefined and known are represented by the green and yellow points respectively. In the real-time experiments, an initial model is generated using a few patterns of a randomly selected event and the parameter values obtained in these offline experiments. In real time, the incoming feature set is predicted as known, unknown, or undefined event. Also, the sounds of absolutely unknown events, including footsteps, toilet flush, washing hands, and opening and closing the doors, are generated. The sounds of the known events, including kettle, vacuum cleaner, washing machine, and dishwasher, are generated in real time to evaluate the acoustic event recognition performance on the known event classes of the initial models. The results of the real-time auditory synonymized experiments are shown in this table, including the precision and recall values of acoustic event recognition and unknown event detection. The acoustic events with the best precision and recall values are closing door, vacuum cleaner, and washing hands. However, the worst result is obtained on the sounds of kettle. In a continual learning experiment, the acoustic event recognition performances are shown in this figure. Also, the number of distinct events are indicated on the acoustic event recognition accuracy line that represents the number of patterns being detected as unknown and adapted into the hierarchical HMM at this point. While the number of unknown events increases, the oxygen recognition accuracy also improves. An average of between 25 and 35 different events are detected in various experiments, in which 100 event sounds with 12,901 audio patterns are introduced. As future work, the number of everyday sounds to be recognized will be increased to the order of hundreds, and the performance of the system will be verified. Therefore, we will evaluate our framework in such more complex environments. Also, the real-time auditory scene analyzers will be utilized with a real robot, where intelligent and autonomous behaviors such as getting closer to the events and tracking to the moving targets in the scenes will be performed to improve the performance of acoustic event recognition.